Okay, so this course, this phasing technology, here we have studied in detail about the different methods of freezing and different types of freezer which we are applying for freezing of fish and fishery product. So while we are applying a low temperature or when we are applying a frozen temperature, when we are freezing the fish, so there is a lot of changes that takes place inside the fish muscles or fish tissue, or that changes comes to the fish while we are subjecting to the freezing of fish or fishery product. Not only in freezing, after completion of the freezing, we have to store the fish into the cold store. We have to store into the frozen storage. So there are also some changes takes place inside the fish muscles or fish tissue, or in the fish also, or fish products also. So what are the changes that associated with this freezing of fish or during the frozen storage? So today we will discuss or we will study in detail about that. So while we are subjecting this freezing, as we know, it's a method of preservation. So in place of freezing on most of the food, it has been observed that there is a less influence of freezing. On most of the foods, that freezing influence or effect is very less. And practically, we can't distinguish whether it is a frozen or unfrozen or thawed fish. So that is the advantage of this preservation method or freezing, that we are not able to distinguish whether it is a frozen or unfrozen or thawed fish. It depends upon the quality. So while we are subjecting the fish for freezing, so the first changes which occurs inside the biological system or the fish is the supercooling. So supercooling, basically it is a phenomenon or it is a condition which is attained by a liquid where its temperature is lowered to below its freezing point. So when we are lowering the temperature below the freezing point of a liquid, so suppose we are subjecting the fish to a low temperature, so inside that fish body, whatever water will be there, so that water first it is going to be super cool. So that super cool, that means below freezing point the temperature will go, but they are not able and they are not going to convert into the solid. They are not going to convert crystallization. They are not going to form any ice crystal. So this is the super cooling. So this super cooling in general need not impair on quality. So that super cooling doesn't have any effect on the quality of the foods. Okay. Then another changes which occurs during the freezing is the after super cooling, there is a crystallization. There is a formation of crystals. So this crystallization is the process of formation of the crystals. So this crystallization generally begins with the nucleation. Again, this nucleation, we know it's a two kind, homogeneous nucleation and heterogeneous nucleation. Homogeneous generally occurs in the pure water. Heterogeneous or catalytic nucleation generally occurs in the food system. And after this formation of the nucleus or nucleation, then there will be crystal growth. And this crystal growth generally it occurs in the fish muscles, basically in two regions, this intracellular region and intercellular region. So the first crystallization or first ice crystal will form in the intercellular space because of the higher in the freezing point. Then there will be a formation of ice crystal in the intracellular region. That means within the cells, there will be formation of the ice crystal. Again, the location of the ice crystal will depend upon the various factor. Say, for example, the rate of freezing, that means whether it is slow freezing or quick freezing. Then the temperature of the specimen while we are subjecting to the this freezing. So at the time of the subjecting the fish to a low temperature, So what was the temperature? So temperature of the specimen and the nature of the cells. So it depends on these factors, location of the ice crystal. So anyhow, the first that ice crystal is forming in the intercellular space because of the higher freezing point. Slow freezing, as we know, in the slow freezing, there will be slow rate of removal of heat from the products. So there will be large ice crystal formation. And these ice, large ice crystal will form in the, first will form in the intercellular space. So what will happen, the amount of water which present between the cells will be converted into the ice crystal. So the solute concentration is increasing. Whatever water will be there, that water will be converted into ice. But the solute concentration will increase, and there will be osmotic imbalance between the intercellular medium to the intercellular space. So there will be osmotic pressure, and because of this osmotic pressure or osmosis, what will happen, the cell will shrink and they release the water into the intercellular space. And also the ice crystal will be a large ice crystal, and it will be sharp in nature. So because of this formation of large ice crystal and the sharp ice crystal, it is going to puncture the cell, and whatever the cell fluids will be there or water will be there, it will be excluded from the cell. So there will be loss of water in slow freezing. So that water will be released during the thawing. While we are going for thawing, that times this water will release from the fish. So there will be again the weight loss will be there. Whereas in case of quick freezing, there will be uniform ice crystal. Both formation will be there, both in the intercellular space as well as the intracellular space. So here we are getting a superior quality of the product. There is no dehydration. There is no drip formation. There will be no thaw drip will be there, because here uniform ice crystal is there, both in the intercellular as well as the intracellular space. So here we will get the good quality product. So that is the second changes which we are facing while we are subjecting the fish to freezing. That is the crystallization. Then volume changes, it has been observed, the if we are subjecting fish, or if we are subjecting a water for lower temperature, the water will be converted into ice. At the same time, the volume will expand. So this expansion of the volume in case of pure water is in and around, or approximately it is 9%. So up to 9% volume will expand. On freezing, most of the food expand up to 6%. Pure water 9% expansion hoga, but food jo hai, food system mein jo expansion hai, that expansion will be up to 6%. It may go up to 6%. And this volume changes during freezing is due to the composition of food. Say for example, koi fish mein ya kisi food mein kya hai hamara? Water ka contribution jyada hai, water ka percentage jyada hai. So definitely the expansion will be more. But again, it depends upon the how much air pocket is there. Jo fruits hai hamara, especially fruits or vegetables, they are also having some air space inside the this tissue. So that air space, if it is there, so if the volume is expanding, so that air space will be filled. So there is not so much expansion of volume if we are freezing vegetable or fruits. Then the fraction of water that fails to freeze, bound water or super cool water. If it is, it depends upon the which kind of water is there. So this water is not going to freeze. So it depends upon the how much fraction of water is there. Then temperature changes. Temperature changes, that means we are subjecting our product to a low temperature. So there is a temperature change from the higher to lower. So there, if we are subjecting the fish from higher temperature to a lower temperature, there will be a contraction in the fish muscles. There will be contraction. At the same time, when it is reaching to the freezing point, there will be expansion, because the water which present inside the fish muscles or tissue, it is going to convert it into ice crystal. So there will be volume, expansion will be there. So there is a two kinds, area of contraction and area of expansion. Area of contraction basically occurs when the temperature is reduced from higher temperature to lower temperature. So first the muscle will contract. But while reaching the freezing point temperature, when there will be conversion of water to ice crystal, then there will be a expansion in the volume. Volume expansion will be there. Then density of ice is 0.92 gram. Here some mistake is there. You can correct it. 0.92 gram per ml. That is the density of ice. Then concentration of non-aqueous constituents. Ye bahut important hai. Hota kya hai? During freezing mein kya hota hai? Water jo hai, ye ice crystal mein convert ho jata hai. To inside the fish or cell ke jo andar mein jo water hai, that water is not a pure water. It is a mixture. It is having some solute. Hai na? Koi salt honge, dissolved salt concentration mein honge, solute concentration honge. So ultimately, while freezing, water is going to convert into ice crystal. But that solute will remain as such. So if we are converting the water into ice, the concentration of non-aqueous constituent will increase. And because of this increase in the concentration of this non-aqueous constituents, this will lead to the this significant change in the pH, titratable acidity, ionic strength, viscosity, freezing point, surface and interfacial tension, and oxidation reduction potential, because of the increase in the non-aqueous constituent in unfrozen water. Then during freezing, concentration of solute may exceed, because we are converting the water to ice. So definitely the solute concentration may increase. Then the temperature at which crystallized solute exists in equilibrium with the ice and unfrozen fish. So this is very, very important. Eutectic point or eutectic temperature. So it is the temperature at which crystallized solute exists in equilibrium with the ice and unfrozen fish of water. So that is the eutectic point. In other terms, we can also say it is the maximum possible depression in the freezing point. Maximum possible depression in the freezing point. That is the eutectic point or eutectic temperature. Okay? Or natural food mein dekha gaya hai, eutectic temperature jo hota hai, -55 to -70 degree C. Okay? So this is one. Then we are having a thaw drip. Thaw drip, jo hai, it is the exudate of tissue fluid. Jo water hai, tissue se water hamara kya hota hai? Release hota hai. Kab hota hai? While we are going for the thawing. Jab hum thawing karenge, means after freezing, we are storing the product in the store, cold store. And after that, if we want to utilize that fish or fish product, we must have to first thaw. So during the thawing operation, there will be some loss of water from that product. So that loss of water is the thaw drip. So volume of drip, it may depends upon the type of product. Kis type ka product hai? And the kis tarah ka freezing method humne apply kiya hai? Whether slow freezing hai, ya quick freezing hai, ya rapid freezing hai, ya cryogenic freezing hai. So it depends upon the which methods we have applied for freezing. Then the condition of storage is also important. So because in the storage we are keeping the three parameters, this temperature, relative humidity, and air velocity, it should be maintained. Then the amount of drip, it may varies to 3 to 5%, and even it may go up to 20%. So this loss of water is going to be economical loss or economical fraud. Fraud generally the processor hote hain wo log karte hain. 1 kg humne fish ko freeze kiya, but jab hum thawing karenge to humko wo mila 1 kg to nahi, kyunki 5% hamara loss ho gaya water. So weight hamara decrease ho jayega, there will be weight loss. So that is that. Another important changes that we are facing in the freezing of fish is the gapping of the fillet. Gapping of fillet mein hota hota hai jo connective tissue jo hai, stroma protein jisko bolte hain, aur connective tissue, it fails to hold the muscle block together in the muscle architecture. That connective tissue fails to hold the muscle block together. So because of this loss in the muscle block ka, jo means ek dusre ko bandh ke rakhta hai, wo ek dusre ko hold karke rakhta hai, wo connective tissue ka jo functional property hai wo loss ho jata hai. So because of this loss, the muscles, fish fillet muscles, will show a gap. We will face a gap. Muscles tissue mein humko gap milega. That is called as gapping. और ये gapping maximum observe किया गया है उस fish में, जो जब वो fish ज्यादा से ज्यादा feed किया रहता है और पेट उसका बड़ा रहता है, और उस टाइम में जाकर के हम जब उसको कैप्चर करते हैं, तो दैट टाइम वी विल फेस ए दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम, gapping ऑफ द fillet. Another one is that, एक तो हो गया ज्यादा से ज्यादा फेड किया होगा मछली. दूसरा क्या है, अगर फिश को अगर हम बिफोर और ड्यूरिंग द राइगर मींस प्री रिगर और ऑन रिगर स्टेज में अगर हम फ्रीजिंग करेंगे, सो दैट टाइम ऑल्सो वी मे हेलो
यस सर Yes, sir.
Gapping, you know na?
Hello.
Gapping. हमने gapping अभी बताया, समझ में आया? Hello. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
हमने gapping अभी बताया, समझ में आया? हेलो
नो सर, बीच में वॉइस सर
अच्छा ठीक है,
वॉइस बीच में सर कट गया था.
ठीक है. गैपिंग जो है, जब कनेक्टिव टिश्यू होता है फिश मसल्स का, जब कनेक्टिव टिश्यू इट फेल्स टू होल्ड द मसल ब्लॉक टुगेदर, दैट टाइम वी मे फेस द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ गैपिंग इन द फ्रोजन फिश फिलेट. ये फेनोमेना उस मछलियों में ज्यादातर देखा गया है जो मछलियां को पेट भरा रहता है और वो अच्छे से खाना खाया रहता है, और उस मछलियों को अगर हम उस समय में कैप्चर कर ले और उसको फ्रीज करें, तो वी मे फेस दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम, दिस गैपिंग ऑफ फिश फिलेट. दूसरा क्या है, अगर मछलियां प्री रिगर और ऑन रिगर कंडीशन में पहुंच चुकी है, उस मछलियों को अगर हम फ्रीज करें, तो क्या होगा, वी मे फेस दिस प्रॉब्लम गैपिंग. ठीक है, हेलो
यस सर,
समझ में आया?
यस सर.
तो मसल्स जो है, फिश मसल या फिश मसल्स फिलेट का जो मसल्स है, उस मसल्स में देयर विल बी कंटिन्यूअस. अगर हम मसल्स को काटते हैं तो हमको कंटिन्यूअस दिखेगा, लेकिन बिकॉज ऑफ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस गैप, वी मे फिश, वी विल सी, वी कैन ऑब्जर्व द गैप इन द फिश मसल्स. व्हाई? बिकॉज ऑफ द दिस कनेक्टिव टिश्यू फेल्स टू होल्ड द मसल ब्लॉक, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी मे फिश द गैपिंग. और दूसरा क्या है, ये कंडीशन कब सबसे ज्यादा हमको एनकाउंटर्ड होगा? जब मछली ज्यादा से ज्यादा पेट भर के खाना खाया रहेगा और उस मछलियों को अगर हम पकड़ लें और पकड़ के हम फ्रीज करें, एक। दूसरा, अगर मछलियां प्री रिगर और ऑन रिगर में पहुंच चुकी है, उस मछलियों को अगर हम फ्रीजिंग करें तो वी मे फेस ए प्रॉब्लम ऑफ गैपिंग। देन अनदर वन इज थॉ रिगर। रिगर का हमारे तीन स्टेज है, प्री रिगर, ऑन रिगर एंड पोस्ट रिगर। सो थॉ रिगर में क्या होता है, जो मछलियां प्री रिगर कंडीशन में ऑलरेडी अटेंड है और उस मछलियों को अगर हम इसमें फ्रीज कर दें तो थॉइंग के समय में वो क्या करता है, रेस्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस को कंप्लीट कर लेता है, ठीक है। दैट मींस ऑन रिगर एंड पोस्ट रिगर। सो इफ द मसल ऑफ द फिश इज फ्रोजन प्रायर टू द ऑनसेट ऑफ रिगर मोर्टिस विल कंटेन साइजेबल प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ अनडिग्रेडेड एटीपी। सो दिस एटीपी विल बी यूटिलाइज्ड ड्यूरिंग थॉइंग। The muscle of such fish when thawed can contract so strongly that a high proportion of tissue water is pressed out from the fillets as a drip, and this phenomenon is called a thaw rigor. In exception case, it may reach to 35 to 50%. So, क्या है, pre-rigor condition में अगर हमारी मछली है और हम उसको freezing कर लें, freezing कर लिया ठीक है, cold store में भी ठीक है, लेकिन जैसे ही हम उसको थॉइंग के लिए लाएंगे तो प्री रिगर से वो ऑन रिगर में जब जाएगा तो मसल्स क्या हो जाएगा, देयर विल बी स्टिफनेस इन द मसल्स बिकॉज ऑफ द डेथ स्टिफनिंग। दिस स्टिफनेस इन द मसल्स, द वाटर विल बी रिलीज्ड फ्रॉम द फिश टिश्यू, मैक्सिमम वाटर विल बी रिलीज्ड। सो दैट इज, दैट कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड एज थॉ रिगर। दैट मीन्स थॉइंग के समय में रिगर मोर्टिस का स्टार्ट होना, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज थॉ रिगर, ठीक है। देन अनदर, एक मिनट, अनदर दैट चेंजेस एसोसिएटेड विद फ्रोजन स्टोरेज, अभी तक जितना था द चेंजेस एसोसिएटेड विद फ्रीजिंग। फ्रीजिंग के समय में जो जो चेंजेस होता है फिश बॉडी में, फिश मसल्स में, वो था। अब क्या है, चेंजेस विच एसोसिएटेड ड्यूरिंग द फ्रोजन स्टोरेज। सो आफ्टर फ्रीजिंग we must have to store the fish, frozen fish to cold store or frozen storage, theek hai। so during frozen storage, this type of changes, physical changes, chemical changes, biological changes, nucleotide changes, postmortem changes, then sensory changes, these are the various changes which we are facing during the cold store. So frozen store is nothing but the storage of frozen product at low temperature for longer duration of time. That is the frozen storage. And the quality changes in frozen storage occurs in a slower rate because of a low temperature preservation, low temperature storage. So that is the frozen storage. Mainly four types of changes we are facing in cold store or frozen store. That is the physical changes, chemical, biological and sensory. Four major type. So physical changes, we are having a two major. That is the recrystallization and freezer burn. Freezer burn kya hai? It is a dehydration or desiccation. Okay. Freezer burn kya hai? It is a dehydration or desiccation or oxidation of fat in fatty fishes. Say for example, sardine or mackerel. Because of the dehydration, because of the desiccation, or because of the oxidation of fat in fatty fishes, it may cause freezer burn. This gives bad appearance or rancid flavor or wet loss and yellow or brown discoloration over the product because of the freezer burn. The intensity of dehydration of fish depends upon the kinds of products, whether it is a lean fish or fatty fish. Fatty fish mein hai तो उसमें ज्यादा होगा, लीन फिश में थोड़ा कम होगा बिकॉज ऑफ द लेस परसेंटेज ऑफ फैट। देन कंडीशन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट, वेदर इट ग्लैसिंग और नॉट। सो ग्लैसिंग वन ऑफ द प्रोटेक्टिंग ट्रीटमेंट वी आर अप्लाइंग ओवर द फ्रोजन फिश over the fish or fish product to prevent dehydration, to prevent desiccation, to prevent oxidation. We are providing a protective treatment over the frozen fish or fish product. Then the condition of the storage medium, that means frozen storage condition, temperature, air velocity, and relative humidity. Then the species of fish, whether it is fatty fish or lean fish. Chemical composition of the feces. Then surface area of the feces, how much surface area has been exposed to the air during the storage. So that is also there. Then relative humidity, we are maintaining in cold store at the rate of 90% to 95%. It should be there in the cold store. Then the place of storage, whether in one corner or other. Ek hi corner mein rakh rahe hain ya fir hum saade corner mein ya maximum space ko utilize karte hain. Then the velocity of air we are maintaining is 0.01 to 0.1 meter per second. Summer season mein kya hoga? Maximum dehydration hoga. Then the value of heat gained of the room, not overloaded the cold store. If load is more, dehydration will be more. So aisa nahi hai pura jaakar ke cold store ko bhar dena hai aur koi air circulation nahi ho, koi relative humidity maintenance nahi ho, to kya hoga? Temperature of the cold ka jo hai, cold store ka hai, wo hamara increase hoga. So there will be a fluctuation in the temperature. Or agar fluctuation in the temperature hoga, so there will be more dehydration or desiccation. So there will be, again, it may affect the quality of the frozen fish or product. Then the storage duration, longer duration, more dehydration. Jyada dinon tak liye rakhenge to jyada humko dehydration hoga. First surface moisture, so external diffusion, and because of this internal diffusion, internal moisture comes to the surface. So this may change to the quality. External diffusion influenced by temperature, relative humidity, air velocity. That is the storage temperature condition. Three parameter. Then internal diffusion depends upon the chemical composition of fish, histological structure of the product, temperature of the fish. Because of this, the internal diffusion may occur. Now, to avoid dehydration, what we have to do? We have to maintain the high relative humidity in cold store. That will be 90% to 95%. Then we must have to apply a protective treatment. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
This glazing is very important. This is the protective treatment that we are applying to the fish before freezing or after freezing. Why we are doing this glazing treatment? To prevent desiccation, dehydration, or oxidation of fat. How we can do? We have to, either we can dip into the ice cold water for a few seconds, or we can spray the chilled water. So before freezing or after freezing भी हम कर सकते हैं, ठीक है? Basically in glazing what we are doing, we are applying a thin layer of ice over the fish or fish product, and the amount of glaze pickup will depend on the temperature of the fish, temperature of the glaze water, size and shape of the product, glazing time. These are the very important. Temperature of the glazing room, temperature of the glazing solution, then dipping time, number of dip, then time interval between the dips. This is very important. That means dekha gaya hai aisa, if glaze is more than 10% by weight, the block weight of the block, then it may crack. Agar 10% se upar agar hum de rahe hain glazing thickness, to kya hoga? Wo glaze mein क्रैक कर सकता है. सो बेसिकली क्या है, नंबर ऑफ डिप, मतलब ग्लेजिंग सॉल्यूशन जो हम बनाएंगे चिल्ड वाटर का, और चिल्ड वाटर विथ दिस एंटीऑक्सीडेंट, तो नंबर ऑफ डिप, कितने बार हम उस पानी के अंदर में हम डुबाएंगे, और कितनी देर तक के लिए डुबाएंगे वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. थिकनेस ऑफ द ग्लेज इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द ग्लेजिंग रूम, टेम्परेचर ऑफ द ग्लेजिंग सॉल्यूशन, डिपिंग टाइम, नंबर ऑफ डिप्स, देन द टाइम इंटरवल बिटवीन द डिप्स. ठीक है. सो वन डिप विल नॉट गिव मोर देन 2% ऑफ द ग्लेजिंग थिकनेस. ओके. सो टाइम ऑफ ईच डिप इज जनरली 1 to 2 सेकेंड. हर डिप में 1 to 2 सेकेंड तक के लिए हमको ग्लेजिंग सॉल्यूशन में छोड़ के रखना है. और इंटरवल बिटवीन द टू डिप और ईच डिप इज 30 सेकेंड. दैट मीन्स जैसे ही ग्लेजिंग सॉल्यूशन में मछली को डालेंगे 1 to 2 सेकेंड तक छोड़ेंगे, फिर जब हम दूसरा डिपिंग करेंगे तो दोनों के बीच का जो ड्यूरेशन होगा दैट विल बी 30 सेकेंड. ओके. और ग्लेजिंग थिकनेस जो है हमारा स्टैंडर्ड ग्लेजिंग थिकनेस होता है दैट इज 0.6 mm. दैट इज द ग्लेजिंग थिकनेस विच इज नेसेसरी टू प्रोटेक्ट द ब्लॉक. ग्लेजिंग थिकनेस 0.6 mm. ओके. ठीक है. हेलो हेलो
सर.
ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है ग्लेजिंग. ये डिहाइड्रेशन डेसिकेशन जो हो रहा था, फैट ऑक्सीडेशन, उसकी ट्रीटमेंट के लिए वी आर अप्लाइंग दिस ग्लेजिंग. ग्लेजिंग इज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ए थिन लेयर ओवर द फिश और फिशरी प्रोडक्ट. दिस ग्लेजिंग वी कैन डू बिफोर फ्रीजिंग और आफ्टर फ्रीजिंग. हाउ वी कैन डू, वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर द ग्लेजिंग सॉल्यूशन इन ए ग्लेजिंग रूम. ग्लेजिंग रूम का जो टेम्परेचर होता है -8 to -12 degrees C. ठीक है. सो वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर द ग्लेजिंग सॉल्यूशन इन ए ग्लेजिंग रूम एंड वी हैव टू डिप द फिश इन दैट सॉल्यूशन फॉर 1 to 2 सेकेंड. सो एक डिप अगर हम दे रहे हैं तो एक डिप में जो हमको ग्लेज का थिकनेस जो मिलेगा दैट विल बी हाउ मच, इट विल बी 2 to 3% एक डिप में. तो अल्टीमेटली हमें 2-3 बार हमको ड्रिप करना चाहिए तो हमको मिलेगा जाकर के 4 to 7% ग्लेज थिकनेस. ठीक है. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउ अनदर दिस फिजिकल चेंजेज ड्यूरिंग द स्टोरेज, कोल्ड स्टोरेज, द रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन. रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन इज द मेटामॉर्फिक चेंजेज. रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन इज द मेटामॉर्फिक चेंजेज इन द ice crystal. Once the fishes or fish products have been completed the initial solidification. Initial solidification, that means jab hum freezing karte hain, that is the initial solidification. So after completion of the crystallization process, while we are storing into the cold store, that times there is a chances that recrystallization may occur. What is recrystallization? It is the metamorphic changes. Changes in terms of number, in terms of shape, in terms of orientation of the ice crystal after the completion of initial solidification. Initial solidification ke baad mein agar kuch ice crystal mein change ho raha hai, either in terms of number or in terms of size, in terms of shape, in terms of orientation or perfection, then it is called as recrystallization. It found in various substances like pure water, ice cream, frozen juice, animal tissue. So most of the food substances it has been found. Rate of recrystallization depends upon the temperature, nature of the sample. Okay. To avoid recrystallization, practically we can't stop the recrystallization, but can keep at minimum level by lowering the temperature at 20, मतलब -20 प्लस माइनस 1 degree C. ये -20 degree होगा, 20 degree नहीं होगा, इसको करेक्ट कर लेना. देन यूज ऑफ क्रायोजेनिक फ्रीजिंग. वी हैव टू यूज क्रायोजेनिक फ्रीजर टू अवॉइड रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन एंड वी कैन कीप इनटू -20 degree C और कोल्ड स्टोर. Then the type of recrystallization, first is the isomass. Isomass mein kya hota hai? Here, fixed mass of ice crystal, that 4 meter high energy to low energy. That means there is a migration, not migration, the fixed mass of ice crystal. ठीक है, सो हाई एनर्जी टू लो एनर्जी एरिया में क्या करता है, वो मूव करता है एंड रिजल्ट्स इन इंक्रीज इन साइज बट डिक्रीज इन नंबर. सो क्या होगा, फिश के टिश्यू के अंदर में जो भी आइस क्रिस्टल होगा एक दूसरे के आसपास, तो फिक्स्ड मास का जो आइस क्रिस्टल होगा एक दूसरे में आकर के कॉम्बाइंड करेगा. सो देयर विल बी ए मूवमेंट ऑफ आइस क्रिस्टल फ्रॉम हाई एनर्जी एरिया टू लो एनर्जी एरिया. So, दोनों आकर के एक दूसरे में फ्यूज करेगा. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, द साइज ऑफ आइस क्रिस्टल में इंक्रीज बट एट द सेम टाइम द नंबर ऑफ आइस क्रिस्टल विल डिक्रीज. व्हाई, बिकॉज देयर इज अ फ्यूजन बिटवीन द टू आइस क्रिस्टल, दैट्स व्हाई द साइज इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड नंबर इज डिक्रीजिंग. देन माइग्रेटिंग रिक्रिस्टलाइजिंग